Hi, welcome to another Google Maps Developers Live. I'm broadcasting today from Sydney on this Australia Day special, hence the ridiculous hat. Today I'll be speaking about Android Photosphere, give a little overview, and how to get those Photosphere images and put them into Google Maps Street View. So first of all, a quick overview of Photosphere. It's one of my favorite features of Android 4.2. So Photosphere lets you take complete immersive panoramic image very, very easily, assisted by the Android camera, and it's just awesome. So let me show you a quick look at what the result is like. So this is when you've shared in Google Plus. So going over to Google Plus, I've got this awesome panorama that I took here in Sydney a while ago. So this is the Sydney Harbour Bridge, looking out over the harbour, all the way over to Luna Park on the right, and you can see Balmain and McMahon's Point in between. This is an awesome, awesome day in Sydney. So yeah, so you can pan around in Google Plus. I've got this great immersive experience. So in this case, the panorama that I took wasn't a complete 360 degree panorama. So I think it was about 90 or 100 degrees or so. So the Google Plus viewer lets me pan in between that range, and it's very cool. And I think if I press this, so this is the flat image that's come back. So for those that know anything about image projections, this is an equirectangular projection. So from there, it then gets warped into this sort of 3D view. And we can also go full screen, which is quite nice. So over to Street View, why would you be interested in bringing this image into Street View? So for a few reasons, you can share the image on your own site. So if you'd like to keep your panoramas private, or if you don't want to share it through Google Plus, or for some reason your panorama hasn't been accepted onto Google Maps, you can use this to embed it on your own site. You can also customize the panorama. So if you, for example, wanted to do some post-processing, bit of image editing, you could change the colors, maybe put some image overlays. And finally, Maps API Street View is very powerful. You can link panoramas together. So for example, if you've taken a photo in the lobby of your business and you want to link that through to, say, a meeting room, or if you're in a restaurant, the waiting area through to some of the tables, you can do all of that using the Maps API. Okay, so a quick look at the Photosphere format. So you can download an image. Now you can obtain this image directly through the Android gallery. If you've shared it through Google Plus, you can download it from the options menu. And finally, some panoramas get accepted on Google Maps, so you can obtain the imagery through there. I think the easiest and the most foolproof way is through the Android camera, but if you've already got one on Google Plus, that's quite good too. So in this case, the image is 3,283 by 956 pixels. That becomes important later on, and I'll show you why. Oh, actually, first of all, let's look at the end result. So Photosphere inside Google Maps. So this is a Google Maps API map. I'll show you the code later on. But you can see there's a very similar experience to the one on Google Plus. You've got this nice warping, if you've got a browser that's capable and fast enough to support warping. So in this case, I'm using Chrome on a Mac. So yeah, you've got this nice thing. And you may notice that you can actually scroll past the bounds, which you couldn't do on Google Plus. This is just a fact that I'm using the Maps API, but you could write some custom code to prevent that. So if you look up, everything's black around, and you'll see why in a moment. So going back. So Photosphere embeds a whole bunch of metadata into the image, similar to how EXIF, if you're familiar with it, is embedded. So if I run the strings Unix utility over the JPEG file, you get back this interesting information. So you can see here there's a URL, ns.adobe.com, but the really interesting part is a little bit after that. It's some XML, it's an RDF embedded metadata, and you can see we've got all these important parts highlighted. So the cropped area image height pixels, image width pixels, you can see if I format it a little better, we've got the cropped area left, top, image height, image width, full pano width, and full pano height. So if you're sharp, you would have noticed that we didn't see 3283 or 956 anywhere there. This is because a scaling factor is applied. So this is important later on. But this is basically what all those numbers mean. So if you the cropped area is the main image that you've taken, and the full pano is the full padded image. So if you imagine 360 degrees on the x-axis and 180 degrees on the y-axis. So the image width should be twice the image height. So the six important values that come back from Android Photosphere metadata is the top pixels, the left pixels, the image height and the image width, and the full pano's height and width. So this scaling factor needs to be applied to all of these numbers. So the easiest way to make use of all of these numbers is to hop over to your favorite image editor. I'll show you an example using Photoshop. And so essentially you need to take the photo that you've taken, pad some black around it. So you basically move the image down and to the right and then pad it out to so that it fills up that full pano pixel values. So just looking here, after scaling those numbers, we take all of them and apply it by that scale factor. So essentially you take that cropped area, image height and width and compare them to the actual values. And then you just scale them down. And then so in Photoshop, you can see here I've gone and added some padding to the left and the top using the relative canvas size option. And then I've just changed the total image value. And so the result of that is something like this. So this is a full 360 and 180 degree panorama. So you can see that the amount of photos that I've taken is quite small in comparison to the full panorama. So from here, we just have to take that image and put it straight into Street View. So we've done a couple tutorials on custom Street View before, but I'll take you through it very quickly. It's really simple to get started. So you start with a Street View panorama object, but you provide a pano provider object, and this is where the custom thing comes in. So if I look at the get custom panorama function, it looks a little like this. You get a panorama ID. So in this case, we've hard-coded it to custom, and you return some metadata about that panorama. So the important thing here is the get tile URL function. And so here we just return a static value. So you could cut up the image and tile it if you like, if it's very large. In fact, it is very large. And you just provide the tile size and the world size. So this is just the image dimensions. Okay, so once we piece all of that together, we get that beautiful Maps API custom street view. So let's just take another look at that very quickly. So all of that code ends up something like this, which is brilliant. And then from there, you can add links to other custom panoramas, which is great. Okay, so let's talk a little bit more about this embedded format. So if we inspect the bytes of this image file, you'll see this FFE1 marker, which is called an App1 marker. So this is used for all sorts of metadata, including EXIF. So the next two bytes denote how large this section is. So in this case, 03FE is that's something like 1,000 bytes. So all we need to do then is to get the next 1,000 bytes and parse that as XML. So I'll show you some example code using Go, but you could do this in any language you like. So here I define an app1 marker as E1, and we essentially scan through all of the bytes until we get FF and then E1. And then from there we go and call the make section function, which is very simple. It just takes in the size and then just returns the byte slice of that much of the file. And then from there the file stops reading. So the code that sort of wraps all of this is very simple. We continually call this next section function looking for the app1 markers until we end up with something that is Adobe XMP. Once we've found something that's Adobe XMP, we parse it. I'll show you in a second the fields that we parse. But we use the Go's XML parser, extract the XMP, and then check that it's a photosphere panorama. If it's not a photosphere panorama, it's some other XMP metadata, so we just keep looking. So from there, once we have all that metadata, we can do these same image transformations that I did in Photoshop using Go's image libraries. Show you that very quickly. So these are all the fields defined as Go structs. So we have the XML name and panoops, which is the IDF description tag. So from there, we just extract the fields that we need, nothing extra. Go does not complain if it gets fields that are unexpected. So from there, we can resize the image using the image library in Go, which is very, very easy. So we create some bounds, and these are defined by the left top and the image's width and height. And then we simply draw that to an image of the correct dimensions and then output it as JPEG. So I'll be making this utility available. Hopefully, I can convert it to an App Engine app and output all of the required JavaScript code. So look out for a post on the Google Maps API Plus page. You'll be able to read all of the code and hopefully iterate on it and do some cool things. So that's it. That's a little overview of Android Photosphere and Google Maps Street View.